So experiment 9 is class B push pull amplifier. The aim of the experiment is simulation of a transformerless class B push pull power amplifier and determination of its conversion efficiency. First of all, what is a class B push pull amplifier? Why the name push pull? Okay, so if you observe the circuit diagram of your class B push-pull amplifier, you have an NPN transistor and a PNP transistor connected in this fashion. That is, you have a common input signal given to both the bases, but usually the input signal is given out of phase to one of the transistors. That means one of the transistor conducts amplifies for one half of the cycle, whereas the other half amplifies for the next half cycle. This would be much clearer in this diagram. We give an input signal, which is to be provided across the base of both the transistors, which are connected this way. You can see the transformer couples the input to the bases. One is given as in phase to the signal, input signal, whereas the other signal for the bottom transistor, that is the PNP transistor, is out of phase. This is the NPN transistor, this is the PNP transistor. And what happens is the conduction happens during the positive half of the input of whatever appears at the base of the NPN transistor. The conduction occurs and the signal across the output terminal is always, as you know, a 180 degree out of phase. So for one half of the cycle, it is the NPN transistor that conducts, whereas for the next half, it is the PNP transistor that is going to conduct. And hence, this output signal that you get looks like this. So there is a slight distortion, which is due to the transformer not being perfectly center tapped. So if at all this perfectly happens, you get a smooth signal which is 180 degree out of phase than that of the input signal. But generally a slight distortion occurs. So we will be simulating and seeing the same in PSpice, and we will also connect an RC load in between in order to reduce the distortion. So this is the PSpice simulation for class B push-pull amplifier with crossover distortion, where you don't have anything. All you do is you take the load across these points and you plot it on the waveform. Even here in the diagram, circuit diagram for without crossover distortion, you have the extra RC component which is present. So in the simulation, we will be seeing both these outputs. Here is a circuit diagram of a class B push-pull amplifier without crossover distortion. The connections are made as shown, and let us look at the simulation. You can see there is no crossover distortions at all. You have a perfect output waveform. Shown here is the circuit diagram for a class B push-pull amplifier with crossover distortion. Make the connections. Give the AC source, connect the transistors as usual, and you can see there is crossover distortion across the output voltage. So this is the circuit diagram for class B push-pull amplifier with crossover distortion.